Between February 4th and February 27th of this year, the town of Grindavik in Iceland might very well see yet another nearby volcanic eruption. This might seem unbelievable at first, but see the data for yourself. For context, the Reykjanes volcanic system activated after a more than year-long pause on October 21st of 2023 after a 2022 intrusion. Because of this, magma built up in a 5-kilometer deep magma chamber 1100 meters south of the Svartsengi geothermal power plant beginning on October 21st. Then, 21 days later, it was sent in a magma run event to the east before flowing both north, although primarily south underground, to form a large magma dike. While this did not result in an eruption, only 2 days later ground subsidence turned to uplift. The situation repeated itself, and perhaps due to the following length of time being longer, specifically 37 days, an eruption occurred in December. After this eruption ended, it would be only another 26 days before the most recent eruption occurred. In other words, as long as magma is still intruding into the 5-kilometer depth magma chamber, then a magma run event can be expected in the same general area about once every 20 to 43 days after the prior magma run event ends. Although we are dealing with a very small sample size, I do not think it is a coincidence that the most recent eruption involved a smaller volume of molten rock than the prior event. What I am trying to suggest is that the amount of lava which ends up erupting or being involved in a magma run event at the Reykjanes volcano is strongly correlated to the length of time since the last such event occurred, assuming that ground uplift due to magma is still ongoing. In my opinion, this process will keep repeating over and over again until either the magma supply to the 5-kilometer depth magma chamber ceases, or a major change occurs which results in magma being sent in a different direction. However, there is more I would like to hypothesize based on our prior 3 magma run events. It appears that the distance magma travels towards the south is roughly correlated to the amount of time between the beginning of a major earthquake swarm and the start of an eruption during a magma run event. For example, on December 18th, it appeared that magma moved 500 meters underground before erupting 90 minutes later. Yet, on January 14th, magma moved 2,020 meters underground before erupting 308 minutes later. Because magma could erupt within Grindavik proper during the next eruption, I am suggesting that the town be closed off to everyone, with no chance of returning until the current buildup of magma at 5 kilometers depth ceases. While this might seem a bit extreme, there is still an ongoing hazard despite the fact that the latest eruption ended only 39 hours after it began. What I'm referring to is the expansion and subsidence of ground, which has formed cracks right below Grindavik in some instances. These cracks did not all form at once, as instead many of them start underground and then slowly migrate upwards. This means that much like a pit crater at a shield volcano in Hawaii, there might not be any evidence that one is forming until the ground simply gives way. These cracks have the potential to not only push buildings off their foundations, but could also swallow anyone that just so happens to be standing above them at the time of their formation. I think that the current hazard zone should remain for several months and not be decreased, as that will be the minimum amount of time in which it is too dangerous to be in Grindavik, in my opinion. There are also gas emissions from the cooling lava to consider, which will take years, as these could also reach potentially lethal concentrations. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Dennis Ward, for supporting this channel.